This is an aluminium Rubik's Cube. It weighs about 300 grams or just over half a pound. They're not new, they've been around for quite a long while, and actually now they're starting to get a bit rare. I've wanted one for several years, but I never actually got round to getting one. So I thought now I would. Movement is incredibly smooth. It's made of aluminium, as I say, but as I understand, the inside is, a lot of the inside is plastic, so it's kind of a combination. A little bit later I'll see if I can take a thing apart without damaging it. So I just do a solve. I've noticed the colours are all kind of like textured, and they're quite a weird colour, like the white is kind of like almost a creamy sort of grey, but so it's not bright colours, it's kind of like dull sort of colours. So let's just do this solve. It really has a nice feel to it. I can tell it's not a speed cube, you know, it's more like a traditional Rubik's Cube. So as usual, I'm using my own method that I devised in 1980, which is basically to do the red side first and then the orange corners and then everything else. Okay, right, so that's a solve. So let's take a look inside it. Yeah, it comes apart just like a regular Rubik's Cube. Right, so this is what I expected. I had sort of seen it on other on websites and stuff. So we've got like a fairly standard Rubik's Cube type core to a mechanism. Actually it's kind of less. It's worse than a Rubik's Cube because these pieces aren't very sort of filled in, so it's quite a cheap mechanism. Yeah, these seem to be solid aluminium, and we've got these plastic centres and like the spider in the middle. The cap is obviously the aluminium part of it. So yeah, it's a nice puzzle, and definitely something I kind of need to own at some stage in my life.